much to work with, really.
There was a moment. There was a moment when we were in that, in the Universal Studio in Amsterdam.
Oh, with
in Australia, when they had built the sort of all underneath what was inside the ruins.
Right.
And, you know,
the ones hanging that we had to go through,
completely covered in all of this plastic, and they told us fire retardant plants, because we're going through them with these huge torches, like literally originally, because it was going to be the only light, and Carter wants it very naturalistic, and the cinematographer, you know, he wants it really beautiful, so they were like, you know, he wants more torches, so literally we would have like flames this high going through small little caverns.
I was wondering
plants.
That during watching the movie.
It was scary. But luckily, the prop department did not lie, and they were flame retardant. There was a few times where it kind of like quivered, almost about to ignite.
But. Yeah, because there's that part where I have to like run through the hole and drop my thing at the same time, and I had to be careful not to like, I had to turn around and not to try to like burn Jenna's hair on fire, and also turn it this way not to burn my leg off.
That was fun though. It was a lot of torch work, you know, which is kind of a fun prop to wield.
Yeah,
you know?
But then also remember we had the vines when we had to go through the hole, and it was like these vines were like, oh, we made them specially. They're made of like soft plastic. It should be
no.
Fun.
They made the rock soft plastic, and then they made the vines
out of wire.
They had all these sharp wires poking out of them.
And we had to scramble, like go through as fast as we can as they're shooting from the side, and we're like climbing through the vines and these wire vines. And it was, we got out of there.
The first time,
with like blood dripping and scratches. Like we still have scars. See those two scars there?
I was going to ask you about scars.
It's from those vines.
That's actually new.
I was going to say, wow.
This is still fresh.
But it was.
Was there a lot of physical damage to both of you on set then? Well, especially
definitely.
You, because of all the knifing. Did you get,
get
to keep any of those scars? Because that'd be pretty cool.
We did have
an
award thing during the week. We passed on this award, and each time you got the award,
it was best of the hill.
Yes,
we basically built this hill that the entire crew had to live on.
Everyone was involved, and so I got the one week was my whole depth scenes for like one full week. So I think everybody felt really bad for me. So they made me this award of the hill and everything, and they're like, "Here's the award, and you have to add something to it." And there was this damn cut in my knee prosthetic that had to be on. Sometimes it had to be on, sometimes it had to be off, sometimes it was on, sometimes no one could figure out when this thing should be on or off. So I basically wore it the whole time just to be safe. So I'd have to go in 2 hours early just to get the thing on just in case.
Right.
So after I got to, you know, get everything over with the death and the cuts and the blood, I put my nice little knee prosthetic right on the award and gave it away as a present to the next person who got the award. It was
a lovely open wound. I mean,
it was a good one.
Beautiful.
But they still have sitting around somewhere.
Somewhere. But I didn't take anything back with me. It was, I think for me, it was a little scary, you know, like being a girl and you know, having like your body has to look a certain way, but I don't think that, I mean, I didn't let it get to me too much. I mean, we all pretty much went on this diet all together just to be, to know what it's like to want something and really like crave it and not be able to have it.
Like a deprivation diet,
yeah.
You know, where we could all sort of take one small aspect of deprivation and sort of experiment with it in our own personal lives that the cast would do. And you know, that we couldn't eat what the rest of the crew was eating. You know, we were all on this thing. We're eating basically like steamed chicken and rice for 3.5 months, going completely insane.
It was
the most beautiful technique of bonding a group of people together for a similar circumstance. Because you understand deprivation in the smallest sense, you can understand it in the largest sense. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So it was really nice to have that to sort of ground us together.
Yeah, you knew every single day what you were eating. It wasn't like, we'd sit around and dream like, what are we going to have when this movie's
done? But you know, the beautiful thing about this film is that it's not, you know, it's not one-sided like most horror films tend to be. You know, there's a little bit of, you know, guy nudity. There's a little bit of female nudity. You know, there's sort of the whole spectrum, which I appreciated as an audience member.
Yeah.
I have to say, I
wasn't the only one.
No, you weren't.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, thank you both very much.
Thank you.